Hi there, and welcome to another video tutorial from Cornflower Iris. Today I'll be making a card to participate in the Colour Throwdown Challenge number 446 using the colours green, yellow and coral. A link to the blog is in the video description. I'm using a stamp set from Tim Holtz called Flower Garden and a pre-scored and cut card base in C6. Using a stamp positioning tool, I'm simply arranging the flowers into an arrangement that's pleasing to the eye and stamping them using a Memento ink pad in peanut brittle colour. This gives a nice subtle colour, and I'm stamping it twice to make it a little bit darker so it stands out. I'm planning to paint over this with acrylic paint, which is less transparent than watercolours, so it helps to have that double stamped outline. The lovely thing about this stamp set is that the stems are included separately, so you can make the flowers as tall or as short as you like them. There's also smooth stems and more raggedy stems, depending on the type of flower. For the background, I'm using distress inks and blending them across the card front. In the bottom corner, I'm using distress ink in crushed olive. And I'm leaving kind of a mottled effect, I'm not trying too hard to get a perfect blend here. You may have noticed in the top left corner of the card, I stamped an extra flower image that I decided I didn't like. So I'm leaving the left hand side of the card blank, since I know I'm going to put something over the top of this to hide it. For the top half of the card, I'm using distress ink in mustard seed colour. This is a lovely vibrant yellow and blends really well with the crushed olive colour. For the flowers themselves, I'm using acrylic paint to colour them. This is Pebeo paint from their Brilliant range, so it's a glossy paint and it's in the colour light green. For the flowers themselves, I'm using Crafter's Choice Royal and Langnickel acrylic paint in the colour Coral Rose. I'm not going to show you all the painting because this is just a very flat wash that I did, so there's a little bit of texture in there but not very much, and this is just to keep in with a very loose feeling summery card. For the centre of the daisy, I'm using some more Brilliant paint. So this will give a nice glossy accent, and this is in the colour bright yellow. For a full list of supplies, please see the video description, and for a really detailed look, have a look at my blog. So to cover up that stamp that I didn't like, I'm using a 1-inch wide strip of green linen cardstock and just cutting it to the length of the card. I then found this pale yellow ribbon in my stash that I'm just wrapping around this to add a little extra element. To add an embellishment to this section, I'm making a double bow. To do this, I'm using a bow maker, wrapping the ribbon around the text twice, and then tying it in a nice way in the middle. It really helps to have a bow maker when doing something like this. Then I cut off the excess of the ribbon and put points in the end. I'm sorry this was off camera. And then using a couple of glue dots, I'm adhering this to the panel. To stick this onto the card, I'm using some double-sided tape because it's a little bit stronger than using tape runner. For the sentiment, I wanted this card to be a thank you card for a friend, so I'm using the English Country Garden stamp set, Beautiful Leaves, and in the top right corner I'm stamping Special Friend in VersaMark ink after preparing the area with an anti-static tool. In the bottom right corner, I'm also stamping You're Too Kind. I'm then going to emboss this with this embossing powder, which is really something special. You can see how much mica is in there. It's by Lindy's Stamp Gang, and it's in the colour Drop Dead Gorgeous Green. So I'm melting that and then using a soft brush to try and get rid of the extra mica powder, but it's so shiny and such high quality mica that it's staying on the card. So I decided to go with this theme, and I'm using a mica mist, it's Tattered Angel's Glimmer Mist in Key Lime Pie, and spraying that just to the side of the card to add an extra element. For the inside of the card, I kind of wanted to keep it plain and simple and light, so I'm stamping You're Amazing, also from the same stamp set, in a Memento dewdrop ink pad in New Sprout, and then the same daisy from the front in the corner just to give a little accent. For the envelope, it's a pre-made envelope that came with the card base, and I'm using some of the beautiful leaves in the stamp set just around the corners. And that's the card finished. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and got inspired. Please do have a look over at the Colour Throwdown blog. I'll leave you with an image of that at the end, and there's lots of links in the video description. You can follow me on social media, Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. And I hope if you like this video, you'll hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks again, and I'll catch you next time.